Well, there are ways, David, of winning gold medals at the Olympics. None of them are easy, but that remains the most difficult.
It is, especially when they shove a hill in like that at the finish. And for the two of them to be battling it out in that way up that hill. And it was a fast time. I think it was probably a minute or two faster than we thought it would be. And that was pretty heroic. And, you know, it's a wonderful feeling, or it must be a wonderful feeling, to enter the Olympic Stadium with a clear gap and knowing that you're going to win the gold medal. But the work that you have to do prior to that is pretty amazing. And, you know, up that hill, that must have been...
About 2 hours and 13 plus minutes ago, we were talking about the Africans, that it was about time they won the Olympic marathon again, but yeah. they've rather failed once more.
They did. They were well up there at the beginning. I think, you know, over the first 10 miles, it was basically a whole group of Africans and one or two others. But they did fall apart. I think the Moroccan in about seventh place was the first of the Africans. And again, it continues to be surprising. A lot of the Africans run a lot of the big city marathons. But certainly when it comes to the specific preparation for a marathon, the Asians at the moment have got it right, you know, Japanese and the Koreans.
Yes. A lot of people in Britain run marathons now. They run the London Marathon and everything else. Wonderful. I think it's marvellous that they do. I couldn't do it.
But these I've managed to avoid it.
You've managed to avoid it. But these guys, I mean, they do beat that 5 minutes for every mile over 26 miles. It is phenomenal the human body can do that.
That is the phenomenal thing. Some of the pictures today, the aerial pictures, gave a sort of perspective and an idea of how fast they are actually going, because quite often it's deceptive. And if anybody tried to run a mile in 6 minutes, it's really difficult. To do it in under 5 minutes for 26 miles in heat and humidity is amazing. And I mean, I know we said about all the different sports, but one of the great things about sport is the amount of work that people are prepared to do to try and get themselves into shape to run well. And out of a games, only three people come away with a medal. But in any one event, but you know, the hard work and the effort that goes into, yeah. Steve Brasso was the first Briton to finish.
Yes.
And he's done well. I mean, again, he races regularly. He won the Berlin Marathon a few years ago. And he's what, I think he's ran about 15th position, Steve Brace.
I feel sorry for the poor chap who came fourth, and came fourth in Seoul.
Terrible.
4
position.
Years ago as well in this. God.
And he, I mean, he's getting towards the end of his career now. And poor devil. But again, you know, he hasn't got a medal, but enormous amount of respect within the running fraternity. And you know, that sort of respect matters a lot for marathon runners. And you know, I think all the runners today deserve great credit.
Yeah, it remains one of the great events, perhaps the one of the great Olympic events, doesn't it? And
I think so. I think again, any event is great, but in athletic terms, I guess there's a special significance about the sprint, the 100 meters. I think there's something special about the 1500, and the marathon retains a unique place. And the good thing about it nowadays is, whereas in the 60s, people watched and wondered but forgot it for 4 years, now with the big city marathons, so many people are taking part in them. They're running 4 and 5 hours and finishing. Mm. And they're getting an idea of what it's like to go through that. And you know, the sensations that they feel running 4 hours are exactly the same as those running 2 hours 20 odd today.
They mentioned in commentary that hill at the end. I suppose we ought to give it one more mention. It does seem odd to have a hill right at the end of a marathon like that. Although I suppose you could have a hilly marathon. They do in the Tour de France with bike rides, don't they? So.
Well, you get plenty of hilly marathons. Mm. But if you're going to have a big hill, it's quite nice to get it over with early on, not to be facing it at the end. And there was a lot of worry beforehand that people would be in great distress at the hill. And you know, obviously we haven't seen anybody yet, and hopefully there won't be. So I guess in a sense it hasn't worked out too badly. But I think a lot of people would have felt more comfortable had it finished in the soccer stadium on the flat, and just to consider the athletes rather than the crowd.
Thanks for the moment, Dave. Let's confirm the result for you. There it is in white and sort of whiter, as it were. So now we've got much more to enjoy on this last day, not least the closing ceremony.